Hi everybody, how is everyone hanging in there? I've had lots of emails. I've also been quite busy lately, so I'm sorry on the lack of videos that have been coming out. But obviously, with being so busy with clients at this time and lots of questions that people are having, I thought I'd jump on today to maybe give people a little bit of reassurance going through this time where people are feeling higher levels of stress, higher levels of anxiety and panicked. Even those that are used to being so social and going out, they now have to stay in. So a lot of people are reaching up and what can I do? I'm feeling panicked, I'm feeling anxiety. And the first thing that I want to do, there's a couple things that I want to do in here for you and give you an exercise as well too, but there's a few different things I'd like to give to you for tools that you can use at home and you can share with others as well. So if you're new tuning in, I am Karen Crisco. I am an intuitive life balance coach and an intuitive medium that also does energetic healing and help people uncover blocks, as well as, you know, times like this, help people reach down to the root cause of it and try to get it to a point where you can deal with it or learn how to deal with it. And having said that and going in from that kind of aspect of things, the first thing is, if you do have fear, if you do have anxiety, I want you to know it's okay. There's a lot of people that say that you have to push it away, you have to keep yourself busy, don't own it. And personally, I feel from the amount of clients I've worked with that you do have to own your emotions, you do have to own your feelings, because when you do tune into yourself, things seem to feel a little bit better, because you're it's almost like you're facing them, you're coming face to face with those emotions. So if anyone says, you know, you need to forget about that fear, you're not allowed to be fearful, you're not allowed to have anxiety, I personally feel that you need to own into it, you need to go into those emotions and feel it and ask yourself, why am I feeling this way? Obviously, we know with everything that's going on, that's a simple answer. But the next level would to be, where is this coming from? Are there triggers from childhood? Has there something that has caused this? Am I, you know, for myself, I know my ego does jump in at times, being that parent of three teenagers and, you know, having to obviously still work and still connect and everybody being confined within the house. There's different outlets that we need to teach ourselves, but teach the children as well, that, you know, it's okay to have the fear and anxiety. Maybe if you have to get the facts about certain things, and you're only going to tap into social media once, twice a day. I know some people are checking in every hour, and maybe you need to limit this and say, I'm going to check in on 3 times a day. Specifically on what's going on, and not just for everything that's going on, but stuff in general as well too. You know, when this does pass, they're great tips to use as you move forward in life, of tuning in to your emotions, acknowledging them, feeling them, and asking yourself, and almost like self-processing it and breaking it down of where they're coming from, so you can go down into the deeper root cause of them. Another thing is, again, so we're, you know, kind of stepping up to our fears and emotions and anxieties, and we are owning them. And then we are switching our routine a bit by eliminating things that cause these triggers, right? To lessen that, to reprogram. And something else that I would like to do today too is, we know, and if you're aware with the chakra system, and if you're not, that's okay. You can still take part and share this to help you, you know, throughout the times of these higher anxieties, of really tapping into the heart chakra. The heart chakra is located kind of in the center of the chest, and it's like a energy vortex, a ball of energy. And in this center, it's regarding all about, you know, deeper, you know, about love. And I guess we're just, that's kind of, I'm not going to go too deep into it, but simple, easy stuff to understand. And the reason why I'm going to pick love as the big one for this is because we need to reassure ourselves that we are loved throughout this time, and that we are sending love to others, that we are still connecting virtually if we can. But if we need to take that kind of anxiety and panic emotion down a little bit, I would like to just kind of go into this heart chakra. So I am going to, as long as this works, I'm just going to put some calming music on here, if it will turn on for me. And of course, it never wants to work when we have this going. All right, so let's see if that works. It's not gonna work. Oh, maybe it's gonna go on now. CD. Okay, so it's just taking its time. I do have this music going on just for everybody right now, just to relax wherever you are. And I want everybody just to take a deep breath in through your nose, and release it out through your mouth. And again, in through your nose, and out through your mouth. And when you're breathing, you're doing belly breathing. So you're not just going to do quick breaths in. You're going to fill up your belly full of that breath. Mindful breathing. So another deep breath in. And release. And if you want, you can go into the heart chakra and you can put your hand on the heart area of this chakra, and you can close your eyes or you can open your eyes. And as we go into this chakra energetically, I want you to visualize, as you're remembering to breathe, because a lot of people forget to breathe when they're doing this, that when you are inhaling, I want you to breathe in the energy of life, the energy of the universe that is around you. So breath in, breathing it all in, all the energy of the universe and earth and air, the purity of it all. And as we exhale, we are going to release anything that no longer serves us, any anxiety that is sitting with us, any fear or panic. You're going to release that in the exhale. And we're going to do that again, breathing all of that good in and releasing it all. And I'm just going to get you to focus on doing that again, inhaling, breathing the life, the love, the compassion that people have at this time, breathing in life energy. You to go into that heart center, and I want you, as you breathe in, to fill your body up with this emerald green. And this emerald green is consistent with the heart chakra for love. And let's go in compassion and connection. Breathe in this emerald green as you see it filling your whole body, right from the top of your head, filling through your face and neck, all the way through your arms, down to your fingertips, all the way through your chest, down through your hips, all the way down through your legs and knees, down to your toes. Let this green light energy fill your body. Let it calm, relax you, but also let it fill you up, knowing that you are loved, knowing that you are safe. Allow this light energy to fill you and fill the heart chakra up, restoring that love, that calmness, that connection within you. Just let it sit. Feel the energy of it. Feel the love. Love and compassion filling our body as our mind is now relaxed and we're now in a different energetic state of balance and calm. Breathing through it. And as you take your heart off your heart chakra, knowing more filled with that love, that calm, that peace. And using this tool is very effective several times a day or whenever you're feeling anxious, that you can go in at this point and fuel up in this heart center. So I hope this helped, these simple tips for you. I don't want to overwhelm you with stuff. I will bring you different tips throughout, but I think this is very easy stuff to do that anyone can do, and it's actually really good for your children to do it if you can teach it for them. You can play any calming music if that works for you, but take time for yourself. You are worth it. You are love. You are incredible, and sending you lots of love and light, and hoping this was of help. Take care, and we will talk to you all soon.